You know, Steve Winwood is one of those musicians that it seems like the older I get, the more I just become amazed and impressed by this guy's capabilities and accomplishments. If we did nothing more than talked about Steve Winwood's teenage years, well, that alone would be enough to be impressive. Before he was 19, he would already perform with what would end up being legendary, the founding fathers of rock, including Muddy Waters, B.B. King, Bo Diddley, Chuck Berry, Howlin' Wolf, John Lee Hooker, Eric Clapton. He would even perform on Jimi Hendrix's studio version of Voodoo Child. In addition, Steve Winwood would be the lead singer and a multi-instrumentalist with three iconic bands from the 1960s, the Spencer Davis Group, Traffic, and Blind Faith. Come down off your throne and leave your body alone. Somebody must change. Over the course of his career, he's collaborated with or performed on recordings with a literal list of who's who of artists, from Joe Cocker, George Harrison, and David Gilmour to Slash, Miranda Lambert, and Government Mule. Due to pressure from his record label, Steve would eventually return to the studio, but this time as a solo artist, which would result in a number of hits throughout the 1980s. So what I find fascinating here is that when we talk about the history, the foundation of rock, and you talk about guys like, you know, Chuck Berry and Bo Diddley and Jimi Hendrix and Eric Clapton and so forth, you know, I find it fascinating that in Steve Winwood, you have a musician that at some point in his career was involved or working with all those guys. And for me, yeah, I wouldn't first become familiar with Steve Winwood. It would be in my mid-teenage years, 15, 16 years old, in the 80s. You know, to me, my first introduction to Steve Winwood was probably Higher Life. And I remember talking to a musician who was much older and much more experienced than me. And we were talking about how I'm fascinated by different styles, different techniques of different musicians. And he said, if you consider yourself a student, then you need to familiarize yourself with Steve Winwood. And he's right. And throughout my life, I've always become amazed at what this guy has done. So this is the moment where I ask you, what are your thoughts on Steve Winwood?